Devon, aka Bubbles. Happy holidays for DJ Mario TV.
I'm Yeah. That man right here, Clyde Williams. Before there was a Michael Jordan, there was Clyde Williams. That's the real GOAT right there. Clyde Williams. So go,
Now we're at the championship game, 50 and over legends. Hancho, today we got the MVP. I don't even know your name, boss. Michael Nurse. He came in late, but once he got in the game, all I saw was buckets, 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 buckets. This is today's MVP, man. How did you do it, man?
You know, I got a great team. You know, I got a bunch of guys that have played basketball before, know what they're doing. I don't need to do much except to stand out there and shoot. You know, those guys get me open. So we defended well. They played hard all game, so we had to, we had to really play defense. You know, and that's basically just what happened.
But it was also your passing, because I saw you also look to pass, so you had both going on. But your jump shot was definitely hot, man, especially in the second half. I was saying to myself, who is this kid? You know, so you had a good game today, man.
I appreciate that. You know, it's an unselfish team. When it's an unselfish team, those passes just come. It's just natural. We come down, yeah, pass it to an open man. Hit this man. Hit the cutter. It starts you as a unit. At Magic Mike Smoke, two S's.
Hey, come here, friend. You got to call this Mike. You're good.
We do what we do, you know what I'm saying? That's what we do. That's what we do.
So this is back to back, right?
Yeah, back to back.
So y'all took it last year, now you're taking it again.
Yeah.
With the same team?
Yeah. Always the same team. That's what we do.
So how did y'all win? Because it seems like y'all was always in the lead, but then y'all had a breakdown. How did y'all come back?
Nah, we just kept running the floor, playing some more basketball, you know what I'm saying, spreading the ball out, getting the shooters involved. That was it, you know what I mean? We had some shots down the stretch. We extended the lead, and you know what I mean? We came up on top.
Instagram, what's your Instagram?
What's your Instagram? What's your Facebook? Ice Cold Buckets.
Yeah.
Facebook?
Same thing.
Ice Cold Buckets.
Ice Cold Buckets.
Thanks a lot, Ice Cold Buckets. Hey, right now we with Honcho, man. This is the Kingdom Legends 50 and over championship game. How did you do it, man?
38 years, man. This is beautiful. We just started the 50 and over. This is our second year. Team Jose, they back-to-back champs. So this is it for me. My man, Kevin. Kevin!
And you say you're going to retire, so Kevin's taking over?
Right, New Kingdom, the voice of Kingdom right here.
Nah, that's what's up. That's what's up.
All right, guys. Thanks.
All right, Kevin, what you going to do now for next year?
Well, we just looking for more. Like if you was watching the game, a legend that pulled up and had a performance, every legendary performance. So, you know what I'm saying? We just going to have more and more legends keep pulling up and just great more action, man.
So now you're taking over. So you're doing Kingdom in the summer and then Kingdom 50 and over next year. Next year will be your first year running this, right?
Yes, it will be. My first year doing it completely alone. You know what I'm saying? A great legendary honcho gaming position. So I'm just trying to bring it to more, uprise it, and just turn up, man.
There you go. Look for Kev this summer, 2020 Kingdom Summer Tournament.
We can be fun.
Again, it's Mr. Paul Energy. I'm here at Manali's in the Bronx on 161st. This is the Kingdom 50 and over Legends. During the week, I'm on Instagram. Follow me on Mr. Paul Energy. On Facebook, Mr. Victor Villanueva, a.k.a. Mr. Paul Energy. Shout out to my family and my friends. It's 2023. I'm looking forward to a summer basketball league tournament in the Kingdom, Rucker, Dykeman, and the Queen of Harlem got something coming up also. Stay tuned.
Quick to get the shit tackled, enemies spit at your best friends, kidnapped and trust no one, got beat.
Hi, my name is Janine Mayers and I'm author of Infinite Love, The Pursuit book series. Happy holidays from DJ Mario TV.
Yo, see you go the way you at. D-Rock and Fella, Cesar Leo De Janeiro, let's see. B.I.G.'s making a scream. You know what I'm saying? What the hell is that mean? He's from the book, getting a stick. Eyes for the labels, in and out. One by one, I'm not denied. Cheers for the way the game goes in the deck. Other MCs, my man, saying that. Walking on to the bridge door.
You're going to Yeah. Ken Taylor, and this is Harlem Muse. And we're here with Flavor, aka MC Grimy, aka, it's gotta be another aka.
Oh, it's the Holy Bunk.
It's the Holy Bunk.
What's the government name?
Shelly Mayo. Shelly Mayo, aka Grimy, DJ Grimy,
MC Grimy.
MC Grimy.
That's my rap name.
And that, what's your ball name?
Call me Flavor.
Flavor. All right, I'm going to assume that you're a guard.
Yes, point guard.
And I'm going to also assume that you've been playing basketball at life.
Yes, 53, been playing since grade school, elementary. I love the game.
So you played high school ball?
Yeah, I played high school. Yeah, I'm not even in college, but I played high school ball instead. And you know, I played, you know, Salvation Army.
Differently?
Yeah. You know, Matt outside league, 35 and older, unlimited, 40 and over.
Do you have any experience either minor or pro or
leagues? No, I played in my pro one time, you know, tryout one time, but other than that, nah, just hooping just like this.
Okay.
Just like this. I love the game. So I got no problem.
Okay. So are you looking forward to March 13th?
I can't wait. I can't wait. Can't wait. I got my whole community coming out.
Wow. Okay. So, have you played in big arenas like that before?
Yes, I played at the Coliseum one time.
Okay.
One time, that was it.
So the rim won't be shrinking.
I'm a love the wrong court. I ain't gonna have no problem.
Okay.
I'm out.
Period. Okay. All right. So how has basketball really influenced your life?
Basketball met a lot of great people during basketball. That's the one thing about basketball. You do meet a lot of great people. And I just love the game. Been playing since I was little. Love watching the game, going to a game. So I love it.
So with this over 50 league, you're probably one of the youngest people there.
I mean, 53, yeah. But 50 and older, you got, they still playing hard. I see that.
Yeah, they're still playing hard.
They still going hard.
So, what do you
want to
say to your fans, to your family, to your people?
March 13th. Of course, all my fans, supporters, and my haters, all y'all come on down and support March 13th, Nassau Coliseum. Please come out and support. I got tickets too. Okay. $7 tickets, so they're going fast.
That's right. All right, that's good.
Thank you. You're ready. I see y'all March 13th. Michelle, enjoy.
Yeah.
Interviewing the Over 50 Ballers. And we have
Michael Allen.
Okay. Everybody that came through so far has an alias, an AKA. So I assume you have one too.
Money Mike. Yes, sir.
That means a shot of money.
Well, my mother said, listen, don't worry, it'll happen one day. I said, Mom, where's the money?
Okay. All right, so we're talking about March 13th, mm-hmm. big game at Nassau, in Nassau, I should say.
Mm-hmm.
Are you looking forward to it? Are you preparing for it? Are you anticipating all of that?
Right, absolutely. So I've been working out since last year with Glenn McMillan. He's in Ajax Park in Queens. So that's how I actually started getting back in shape. I was looking at the Over 50 Ballers on, you know, on Facebook. And I'm sitting home and I'm just doing really nothing, retired from the city. And, you know, I said, let me go out here. You know, I see a lot of the old guys that I don't know. Let me go out here. Anyway, I started going in with Glenn to Ajax Park. And then from there, of course, I hit Brooklyn. But I'm definitely anticipating a workout. We were working out 5 days a week. Now it's down to 3 days a week. 6 a.m. in the morning until 8:45. So I'm kind of back in shape now, and definitely I'm excited about the Nassau Coliseum situation.
Cool. So have you been playing basketball your whole life or adult life?
As far back as I can remember, I started playing basketball I started playing basketball when I was about 9 years old. I kind of had a knack for it. I had five brothers, including myself. So everybody had their own little thing. My oldest brother was into karate, my other brother was doing something else. But I like basketball. So yeah, I was about 9 years old. And then my mom brought to my attention a couple of years ago, which I was, unaware of. She said, look, Mike, she always go through the old photos and stuff. She said, look, she handed me a piece of paper that said, I won a dribbling contest in the second grade. I promise you. I said, Mom, you've been holding this all this time. What's going on? So, yeah, so since about, like 9 years old.
So you played like high school now?
I did play for Andrew Jackson High School for a short term.
Their name sticks out to me. They had a pretty good squad.
Andrew Jackson, So, Andrew Jackson played in some local tournaments in St. Albans, Queens, as well as, out here in Brooklyn, of course, with, Glenn McMillan again.
Yes.
Appreciate that brother a whole lot, man, because he's the one keeping us going. I tell guys, do you know any other tournaments in our communities that's running a 50 or 60 in the league?
So, you played in college ball or?
I played for LaGuardia College for short term again. Nothing serious.
Semi-pro?
Semi.
Semi-pro?
Yeah. So, nothing serious, And then the streets kind of got a grab to me.
Okay.
And I fell off for a minute, but God said, not yet. Come on back, bro. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? He brought me back. So here I am.
So how do you feel like basketball has influenced your life?
Oh, man. Well, it has influenced me because one, it keeps me occupied. It keeps me healthy, off the streets. If anybody wants to find me, they know where to find me at. He's in the gym. I get in trouble at home with the little lady because...
Too much gym time.
She got his own checks. Hold up, wait a minute. You did basketball. All you do is play basketball. I said, well, I could be hanging out on the corner or in the club where you can't find me on the,
So you think it's, for you, it's been a positive influence? Keeps you out of trouble?
Absolutely. Keeps me out of trouble. And again, it's the love of the game.
Mm-hmm.
It's really the love of the game for me. And it keeps me healthy. It keeps me strong. I go to the doctor every 3 months, get my little checkups and, everything. And, I'm just, it's a blessing to still be here. What I've been through in my life, and we not going to go into that.
That's a different interview.
But from there to here,
trust me.
People look like, wow, okay.
That's good, man. It's great to see you.
Yeah.
And it's also, for me, it's just inspirational to see you basketball running and doing your thing.
Absolutely.
I was never a good basketball. On my best day, I was almost at my best. My brother played college ball. But I like the game. Because I'm an older man myself, and I stay busy. And normally people in my age range are very sedentary.
Right.
Just kind of,
laid back, chill, that's it.
I don't know, they just waiting for the Grim Reaper to show. But just to see you guys play, I just wanted to put that out there. One of these interviews that is very inspirational for me. And just your example is worth a lot. You may not know it, and the people that's come by, or people who can't do it.
Right.
And that is inspiration. And I don't think you should ever think that what you're doing don't mean something.
Right.
You know what I mean? I know it means something to you, but it means something to people who, you know, check you guys
out. Well, I said that, you know, I'm going to some kind of way stay in the game. As long as God gives me the ability to run and jump and play, I'm going to do that.
Right.
I said if I do one day decide to not play, and I mean in tournaments, because I'm going to always play pickup ball or whatever, but I also went to school to become an official basketball player, IBO, you know, referee, so I'm going to run regardless, you know, and I have to be in shape because the kids that I do, they run. So I'm going this way, so yeah. So I'm always going to be involved in this sport.
Okay, cool. So I'll be seeing you on the 13th.
Yes, sir.
March 13th, if I don't see you before
then. Right after my birthday, as a matter of fact.
March?
March 9th.
I'm March 2.
Huh?
I'm March 2.
Where you at? Where you 20, at?
27. 27.
Oh, the 27th.
Yeah,
oh.
Both 9, so.
Okay,
see
you. There you go. Absolutely.
All right, brother. Thank you.
Thank you for the interview. Yes, sir.
Yes.
Pleasure. Yes. Thank you so much. Okay, Michelle.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Monica Gray. We are out here in Union Square Park on Sunday, August 26th, honoring my nephew, Hamed French Gray, his legacy by feeding the homeless and or people in need, as well as giving them clothing. So my nephew passed away 2016 at the age of 24 years old, and he started on his 21st birthday. He decided, you know, homeless people have birthdays too. So before he went partying that evening, he said during the day he went out and he started feeding and providing socks, t-shirts, undershirts and all for the homeless. So in honor of his memory, we continue in his legacy. So that's why we're here today. We're here, 14th Street, Union Square Park. Started at 11 o'clock, we'll be here until 2 o'clock p.m. And we'll be here every year following. His birthday is August 28th, so whatever that Sunday is closest to his birthday, we'll be here. Join us next year. Thank you.
Morning, peace and blessings to everybody. I thank the Creator for being here this year for our cousin Hamed, and we continue in his legacy to give and help others. And we thank the Creator for this day. Peace and blessings.
How you doing? My name is Ja'Kyra Newman. This is my third year recording the official Ham Day giveaway. Miss Monica, I love this lady. And her man, French Gray, rest in peace. And we're going to make this special for you today, brother.
Had to come out and show love, because family is family, and I'm not going to say that, family comes first. So I had to come out and make time to be here to support Monica, my brother Marion. It's nice to be important, but it's much more important to be nice.
So my nephew passed away 2016 at the age of 24 years old, and he started on his 21st birthday. He decided, you know, homeless people have birthdays too. So before he went partying that evening, he said during the day he went out and he started feeding and providing socks, t-shirts, undershirts and all for the homeless. So in honor of his memory, we continue in his legacy.
What are we doing?
Feeding the needy.
And why are we doing it?
For Hamed.
Why are we doing it?
For Hamed.
What is today?
Ham Day.
What is today?
Ham Day.
And what are we doing? What are we doing?
Feeding the needy.
And why are we doing it?
For Hamed.
Why are we doing it?
For Hamed.
What is today?
Ham Day.
What is today?
Ham Day.
And what are we doing?
Thank you.